committee members are, and I welcome input, feedback from members of the let's go to Mary first.
Hi, everyone. I'm Mary Burwinkle. I'm the treasurer of the Democratic City Committee. I'm on the executive committee, and I've lived in Plainfield for 36 years. I am a lifelong Democrat.
Sure.
And I do have some feelings about this. I communicated by email with all the city committee members last week, but I don't want to belabor this for those of you who read that. But here's my thoughts about this. First of all, I want to say that I think you're a good mayor. I think that you have three really good department heads. I think that your boards and commissions are staffed with good volunteers that you appointed who are getting a lot of work done. I don't have any problem with you as mayor, okay? The problem I do have is that Union County Democratic Chair is a big deal to all of us. Because in very subtle and not so subtle ways, all those appointments change. All that stuff changes depending on who is the Union County Democratic Chair. And I was dismayed that you would put your name on a list for Senator Scutari without asking us, because when it comes down to it, the 68 of us have a vote. You have one vote because you are a member, you are an elected member of this committee. If you were the chairman and not an elected member of this committee, you wouldn't even have a vote. And part of the reason that I was annoyed about it is this happened to you and me before. In 2016, you issued an endorsement of Bullock for governor, and that came out of the blue. And that was not run by the committee first. And at an executive committee meeting at my house, when we were working on the bylaws, I said to you in front of a bunch of people, I said, look, respectfully, you shouldn't do that. Because you're not, once you're a party chair, if you give an endorsement, everyone thinks everyone is lined up behind you. Believe me, the minute you said you were going to endorse Nick Scutari, he said, 68 votes from Plainfield are now mine. You know, so I really take issue with your taking positions without asking all of us first and at least getting a consensus. And you told us a long and winding story that happened over more than a month now, you know, and we talked about that. And you know, when that started happening, this is a big deal to us. Call a committee meeting. Say that the assemblyman's unfortunately very sick. He's probably going to resign as Union County Democratic Chair. We should all be discussing what we're going to do about that. So I just want to make sure with you that I don't have a problem with you as mayor, but I do have a problem with you doing this stuff without talking to us first. My second issue is that, like, I am supporting Colleen Marr, and when I go up there, I'm going to vote for Colleen Marr. And I'm voting for her for a number of reasons. First of all, she's a woman. She has passed over once before, and I don't want to see a woman who has done her piece get passed over, okay, first of all. The second reason is, from what I can see, Colleen Marr is like was always a good friend of Plainfield. She and her counsel come to our stuff. I know Jack Molnar, who is her key supporter on that council, because he comes to so much of our stuff. You know, Colleen hired RPMUA to pick up their recycling. We are on the Raritan Valley line. Colleen is a staunch proponent of the one seat ride. Colleen has spoken at least once, I know, to one of our developers about development along South Avenue. I know that Colleen has spoken to some people about pilots. People had questions about pilots. Colleen shares a border with us. Colleen shares their South Avenue business district and our South Avenue business district run right together. And I think that might be a better fit. I acknowledge Senator Scutari walked into the room. I don't really know Senator Scutari. I probably shook hands with him once. But I do say, I brought a letter that I wrote 2014 to Senator Scutari when I was trying to get somebody to finally put our charter study thing through the legislature, and I never even got a response that I can't help you. So, you know, with all due respect, Senator Spitari, I don't know you, and I think that Colleen is a good choice. I spoke to Colleen on the phone last night, and this is what Colleen said. Colleen said that she believes that Plainfield is the biggest vote getter for the 22nd district, and that as a result, we need Plainfield to bring those votes home. As a result, she strongly believes that Plainfield should have a seat in the assembly, that if she was Union County chair, she would not try to move the assembly seat from Plainfield. And I said to her last night on the phone, I said, can I go to the meeting tomorrow and can I get up and say that you said that? But I talked to you last night on the telephone and you said that, and she said yes. So, with all due respect, this is a wonderful source of democratic discourse. For all of those reasons that I just said, I'm gonna stick closer to home and I'm gonna support Colleen Barr, and I'd be happy to talk to anybody else who wants to do that.
Thank you, Mary.
Thank you. She said that.